I have no idea where my interest in vehicles comes from. I think it might come from a combination of Cars, the movie, and also just, I like to go fast. It's fun. The MIT Electric Vehicle Team is a student team on MIT campus made up of both undergraduate and graduate students now. Mostly what we do is we take commercial vehicles and we convert them to electric vehicles, and recently we started converting them to hydrogen-powered vehicles. Our team historically has very much liked to look at what do we think the future of vehicle technology is going to be, and what are the technologies that we can develop coming into the next years of transportation, and also to provide hands-on experience for undergraduates in those future technologies to prepare them for careers in industry and also academic research. So I guess if you ask why is the team building a hydrogen-powered motorcycle, to some extent it's because why not? Can we do this? And all of us are just very curious about this idea of, can we make a hydrogen-powered motorcycle that beats a gasoline motorcycle?
When I first found the team, the project was just so fascinating and so unique among other build team projects that's what drew me in the first place. Coming into this, and I think a lot of people from the same background would think about hydrogen this way, where in school you learn about it in its chemical sense, so you know you're familiar with the capabilities it has as a reactant, but I hadn't been introduced at all to fuel cell vehicles, and now I've learned a lot more about them, why they're a good thing to put on a car, why they make sense, whether they're competing or complementing battery electric vehicles, and as someone who's sort of just getting into it, it's been interesting to learn a lot more about that.
A hydrogen vehicle works similarly to a battery electric vehicle with a range extender. So you have a motor, and the motor drives the wheel. There's a motor controller that converts DC power into AC power for the motor. The motor controller draws power from the battery, the motor controller powers the motor, and the vehicle moves forward. The hydrogen system is kind of attached in parallel to the battery as like a charger. Over a long period of time, the fuel cell is just continuously recharging the battery as the battery is taking all the variable loads from an electric vehicle. But as long as the average power output of the battery is lower than the power output of the fuel cell, the battery never drains charge. In a hybrid vehicle, you have a gasoline engine that is turning a motor that's recharging your battery. So it's kind of similar to that idea, except a hydrogen system is fully green.
But hydrogen is one of those things where it seems like it's very hard to access, and it is. You have to, you know, take it out of water or take it out of other molecules, which is one of the reasons that we haven't been using it in the past when it's such an energy-dense fuel.
There's this huge chicken and egg problem with hydrogen right now, where it's like nobody's buying hydrogen vehicles because you can't fill up a hydrogen vehicle at a gas station. There's not enough charging infrastructure, and nobody's building hydrogen infrastructure because nobody has hydrogen vehicles. And it's like this back and forth, where do you start? So one of the things we're hoping to do with our project is prove that this is possible and also document it to the point where others can use it to also build these vehicles. And if we do that, then we hope that will accelerate the demand side and the consumer side of hydrogen vehicles to hopefully facilitate the development and infrastructure. We've done the proof of concept, so the next step for us is push it to the limit of what is possible. How far can we go? How fast can we go? Can we beat a gasoline bike? And I think that's one of the questions we want to answer. And for me, that's a super exciting question, because it's like, we don't know what the answer is, and we're gonna find out.